Sift through that pile of slackjaw, will you, dearie? You can have his boots and knickknacks, but leave the bones for me. Careful, might still be hot. What's left of Slackjaw. I guess I should thank you for killing him for me. Guess it wouldn't hurt you sifting through his belongings. Just leave me his bones.
Your way into such interesting places, Corvo. Crawling out of those flooded ruins, winding your way back to the pub where you last saw Emily. Where is she now? How does it feel now, knowing your allies betrayed you? Strange how there's always a little more innocence left to lose. And Dowd, you just killed the greatest assassin of the age. Did you do it for love of the Empress or Emily? Or was it the primal desire to rise above other men? Do you even know why?
No! Oh, it's you, Corvo. Thank the stars. We all thought you'd been killed. Except for Samuel. He seemed sure you'd survived. I saw him on the river shortly before the killing began. He was smart enough not to come ashore. But I'll bet he's still out there. Looking for you is my guess. Havelock called us into the yard. But I wasn't feeling well. I just watched from the attic. The Admiral brought his cutlass. He stuck Wallace through the eye with it. Then he did Lydia. Callista he shot in the back with his pistol. Emily saw it all. Havelock kept yelling something about the things he'd done and how no one could ever know. Pendleton wouldn't even look anyone in the face. They said it was time for Sokolov and went off to his cage. I don't know what happened after that.
Did you do that?
Emily was there when the killing started. Poor child. I hope she hid her eyes. The Admiral said that Martin was right. I guess they talked about it. And they started to worry they'd get executed for all that they'd done, going after the Lord Regent and his allies. I suppose it's why they've poisoned you too. I thought Lydia would squeal on me at the end. She just told Havelock to screw himself. And died.
What a day, huh? That'll be a great party tonight. I was only a kid at the last coronation. We even make it to tonight. Will you look at this mess?
Relax. One of the officers said he was dead. Poison thrown in the river. If you ask me, he's long gone. Threw the mask in the river, left town.
That's what a rational person would do. Not this guy. You have to understand the criminal mind. I hear they had to hide the Caldwin girl from him the whole time they were working with him. I heard they locked him in a cage and only let him out at night.
The criminal mind, huh? So what's he doing now?
Waiting. He's probably watching us right now. With that crazy mask on. Creeping closer and closer, ever closer, until...
Cut it out. What's so impressive about Corvo, anyway? Who's he got up against? A couple of high overseers, a couple of noblemen? He could never stand up to men with our training.
Well, now I do hope he shows up. I want to see you run crying for the cover of the tall boys out back.
Like you were, the other night.
What was I supposed to do, stand there and get hit by rocks?
They were just kids.
They were a gang. I hope Lord Regent Havelock sends the tall boys in to level the place. It's gonna be a new era.
Having a 10-year-old on the throne isn't gonna cure the plague.
High Overseer Martin says it will. He says we were cursed when the Empress died by Corvo's black magic, and the rats are never gonna leave until we had a real Caldwin back. He says the Outsider follows Corvo around.
There's some curse on this city, that's for sure. I'm still trying to forget working in the flooded district.
Don't remind me. Before we go, I'm gonna stash a few bottles of wine from the cellar. Take them out of here with us.
Just make sure Corvo's not hiding down there first. Maybe you're right about that guy.
Did you hear Morris was dragged off by the overseers for some black magic nonsense?
Bug someone else.
Got you now! Someone help me out! bastard! Dump you in the river!
Someone's down. Attention, Dunwall citizens. With sad hearts, the City Watch must announce the death of the Lord Regent, Hiram Burrows. May his spirit fade from this world and suffer no more.
I, Admiral Farley Havelock, humbly accept the mantle of Lord Regent of the State of Bristol and all of its imperial possessions, notably the capital city of Dunwall. I fervently hope my tenure will be a short one, and that the rightful heir will take her place within a mere decade or so.
Refreshing to converse with someone on my own level.
I couldn't agree more. Your expulsion from the Academy was a crime against natural philosophy.
Which might have pointed out at the time, but it's pointless to hold a grudge. I want to ask you.
About the elixir, yes. And I need to discuss your tonic. Why have you not tried the homeopathic solution?
And where am I to find the subjects? I can't recruit from prisons as you do. But it's forced me to work with another agent derived from...
Corvo, good to see that you still breathe. The city would not be the same if you were not with us. I've completed Piero's work on an arc pylon, but only just.
With this device, we can send a powerful electrical signal through the nervous system, merely rendering our enemies unconscious, or they can be reduced to ashes. I've attuned it so that we will be safe from the functions of the device. It will only trigger in the presence of our enemies. This arc pylon is more powerful than the older design. It will function at a greater range, striking down our foes while ignoring us. I need my final sequence, which is recorded in the blueprint for this device. Havelock was inspecting it before the killing started.
returned the blueprint to me. It was in his bedroom before he left. Hopefully, it's still there. You may navigate the fields of battle with ease, but Sokolov and I are not as gifted in the same way. Without the Arc Pylon, it is only a matter of time before they put an end to it. I'll do what you want, but ask quickly.
Complete the job.
Why is no one making rounds over here?
This better not be a joke.
Someone there?
Oh my God. Oh dear.
This better not be a joke. What
the?
The Arc Pylon is complete. Now to activate it.
With this device, we can send a powerful electrical signal through the nervous system, merely rendering our enemies unconscious. or they can be reduced to ashes.
What is your opinion, Corvo? I should have guessed you'd want to act decisively. It's a simple adjustment, and we will be ready. All is ready, Corvo. All that remains is plugging in a whale oil tank to power it. Will you do the honor?
When this arc pylon is charged, no one will dare come near us.
Amazing! Destruction on a grand scale. Defies description. So many lives silenced in an instant.
Cornell, I hope you find this. I'm devastated. The girl I've been caring for is gone. Emily is her name. Yes, that Emily. Daughter to the Empress. She's gone. They took her away in a boat this morning. I don't know where, and her hair hadn't been combed. I worry who will look after her. I didn't even get a chance to say goodbye.
Thought I'd find you here.
It never pays to bet against you, does it? I saw the signal. I knew you'd be back, Corvo. I knew it. We should start off soon. I've been feeling something in my bones, and if it's plague, well, I can't be counted on to drive this boat much longer. Good. Then it's one more trip across the river to where it meets the sea. That's where the Lord Regent was building his new lighthouse. Ought to be something to see.